Many people instantly recognize adagio for strings, but they might not be so quick to recognize the name Samuel Barber, the man who composed the work. But when Adagio for Strings was premiered on a concert of the NBC Symphony Orchestra on November 5th, 1938, there was also another piece by Samuel Barber on the program as well. Famed conductor Arturo Toscanini led the NBC Symphony and was a household name in the days of these radio-broadcasted performances, and in 1937, he was putting together new programs for the following year, and he wanted to try and feature American works. Toscanini was infamous for not liking or programming American composers or their compositions, but he reached out to fellow conductor Arthur Rodzinski, who had just performed Barber's Symphony No. 1 in Salzburg, and the equally unreceptive Austrian audience enjoyed the American composer's work immensely. So Toscanini wrote to Barber, and the composer responded with not one, but two works. The slow and sorrowful Adagio, which Barber had reorchestrated for a full string section from the earlier string quartet, and the Essay for Orchestra, which he had recently completed. Toscanini hadn't thought to reply, and Barber became angry, thinking the maestro had not liked the works and that he wouldn't be performed. His lover and fellow composer Giancarlo Menotti visited Toscanini, and Barber did not join him. Toscanini clarified to Menotti that he planned on performing both works, and the composer had no reason to be upset with him. Both pieces were successful, and while the Adagio for Strings might have become a much more culturally important work, being featured in films like The Elephant Man, Platoon, and countless others to the point of comedic pastiche, the essay is also an important musical offering. Barber wrote two other essays, one in 1942 and the third in 1978, which facilitated the renaming of this one as the first essay for orchestra. The essay was a musical form Barber had utilized and had success with prior to this orchestral essay. He wrote a few essays for piano and devised a somewhat sonata-like form, but with more emphasis on one central concept or theme, and a leaner and more economic succession of musical events than, for example, the first movement of a standard symphony.